Hey, what's going on, bikers? Pierce here with Electric Bike Report. We're in the beautiful desert of St. George, Utah, and today we have the Beach Bum from Tower. The Beach Bum is a Class 2 cruiser-oriented electric bike that comes with a 500-watt motor and a comfortable geometry. Throughout this review, we'll dive into how this bike performs and if it's the right bike for you. So let's get on with it. So the Beach Bum from Tower is going to be a good bike for those who don't want to spend a terrible amount of money on a solid e-bike. This bike has enough power to boost you up the hills, and its geometry is also comfortable enough to keep everyone comfortable when they're riding. The way this bike is set up is going to be good for anyone who does want to cruise around town or on a boardwalk by the beach. It's a very casual-oriented bike. There's not going to be any performance-related things on this bike. This bike is for the joyrides. So the Beach Bum comes with a 500-watt rear hub motor from Tower. This motor is capable of 65 newton meters of torque, and it's going to get you hovering around 15 to 20 miles per hour when you're riding in your higher assist levels. This is a beach cruiser, and I have tested a lot of bikes with 500-watt motors, and I wanted to see how this motor compared to the rest of the ones that I've tested. To do this, we went to one of the steepest hills in town and decided to climb the hill on throttle only and in maximum pedal assist. Between these two tests, we can really see how this motor performs on its own and with rider assistance. So the Beach Bum 2's 500-watt motor comes with 65 newton meters of torque, and we're going to see how that applies to the hill today. All right, pretty solid acceleration. The motor has a little bit higher pitched whirring noise. Motor cut off right there, and now it's back. Kind of cut out on me there on the flat ground, had lost some momentum before the hill. It's still holding some decent speed. We're at about 13 and a half miles per hour, and it definitely sounds like the bike is feeling it a little bit. Not too bad as far as speed goes. I am feeling some vibration. I think that's just some motor feedback right now. Hello. So as far as speed, this bike's doing pretty good. As far as the way it sounds like the motor is definitely working pretty hard right now. Getting up another steep part of our hill here. So yeah, I am feeling a lot of vibration. I think that's probably from the motor. This bike is also fully rigid, so I feel pretty much everything the bike feels. There is a lot of rocks near the top of our test hill right now for some reason. Looks like someone wanted some obstacles. And we are crossing the top at 17.9 miles per hour. Okay, so main impression with the throttle only test there is it was decently fast, but it also sounded like the motor wasn't too happy with it. Good to know. Let's see how pedal assist level 5 is. So that throttle only test, the motor vibrated quite a bit, but we did go pretty fast. Now we are going to do the pedal assist level 5 test. We'll see how manpower plus that 500 watts of power and 65 newton meters of torque adds up. All right, here we go. So noticeably slower acceleration out of the gate there. Did take pedal stroke or two to really get going, and I'm noticing the motor did shut off again right there. It's not really doing itself any favors before we get to the steep part of our hill. And I'm pedaling with the same difficulty I do in all these bikes. So I am in the hardest gear right now. It still feels decently easy to pedal. I honestly wouldn't be surprised if our throttle only result was faster with the way this thing just shut off at the bottom there. At about 12 and a half miles per hour now. Hello. So the gearing on this is relatively easy. And what I mean by that is I'm in the hardest gear right now. I'm not pushing too hard. And the bike is still going up the hill pretty well. Not the same amount of vibration that I felt the first time. Kind of made my butt feel like it was gonna fall off on the throttle only test. But it feels a lot smoother when you're helping the bike out too. I don't think the motor is red lighting like it was before. The smoothness is definitely there as far as once the bike is engaging, but I'm kind of wondering why the bike will cut out like it did on both the throttle only test and the pedal assist level 5. That kind of hindered some of our momentum going into the hill there. With all that being said, I did get up that hill a little faster than I was expecting to, feeling wise. We'll see what our results are though. When I climbed our test hill in throttle only, it took me 1 minute and 15 seconds with an average speed of 14.5 miles per hour to reach the top. While the result was respectable, there was a lot of vibration and feedback coming from the motor area. It definitely felt like the motor was working with the way it was making noise and also the way it felt below me. I had a lot of feedback and I actually kind of had to relieve sitting on the seat with my legs a little bit more just from all that vibration that I was feeling. When I was in pedal assist level 5, thankfully that vibration went away. It felt a little bit smoother. I reached the top of our test hill in 1 minute and 12 seconds with an average speed of 15.1 miles per hour. One thing that I noticed on both tests is it was kind of inconsistent when the motor would decide to engage. There is a straightaway before we reach our hill, and this is usually where our test bikes gain some momentum to help them make it up the steeper parts. This bike actually ended up cutting out on the maximum pedal assist test, and it kind of hindered my momentum. Because of that, our results are pretty close to one another, and each result kind of had its pros and its cons. As a whole, I can tell this motor is powerful, but I do think it needs to be refined and maybe recalibrated to engage a little bit more consistent and smooth. One thing that I noticed on our hill test is I actually never had to shift out of the hardest gear. This bike comes with a 7-speed drivetrain. The derailleur brand here is not one that I've heard of before. It's called Skillful, and it does have pretty good shifting. It's connected to a Shimano thumb shifter, which I am a fan of. Shimano always puts out good stuff, but I did notice this is a little bit easier gearing than I was expecting for a bike like this. Because of this, you might not go quite as fast on flat ground, but when it comes to hill climbs, you're definitely going to have 7 gears that you're able to climb hills in, even if your motor assist isn't on max power. Overall, I think this Skillful derailleur does a pretty good job. I am a little concerned about replacement parts just because it is a brand that I haven't heard of before, but no complaints so far. I think the gear range is good for being a casual bike. It could be a little harder to make me go faster on the straightaways, but as I mentioned, on those hill climbs, it does a good job helping me spin. So the Beach Bum 2 comes with a 48 volt, 14 amp hour battery, which is tucked in pretty nicely below the seat tube here. This battery comes from Tower and Samsung, and you have your charging port on it right here. This battery is about an average size, very similar to the motor. It is a 14 amp hour battery, which is around in the ballpark of what I'm used to seeing on the bike. While the specs are the same, that doesn't necessarily entail that the performance is the same. Because of this, we conducted what we call a range test, where we pedaled this bike on the lowest pedal assist level and the highest pedal assist level. Between these two results, we got a good idea of the true real-world range that this bike provides. When our test rider pedaled this bike in the lowest pedal assist level, it took 75.72 miles with an average speed of 10.6 for this bike to die. That's super far. And one thing that I did notice is the pedal assist level 1 didn't really help as much as some of the other pedal assist level 1s did. I'll get more into that in our circuit test section, but just know pedal assist level 1 kind of just wakes the bike up. Your display is going to be on, you might feel the motor kick in here and there, but if you're truly wanting the feeling of an e-bike, I would definitely recommend boosting up at least another level or two. When I did this test on maximum assist, it took me 39.67 miles with an average speed of 17.73 miles per hour. This result was solid, especially because my average speed wasn't too far off the max speed of 20 miles per hour. The motor engagement did feel a little sporadic. As I mentioned in the hill test, there were some times where it just simply cut off and I had to make back up some speed there. And overall, I think it evened out. Sometimes the motor lag, I think, benefited the range because it wasn't engaging all the time. And other times I think it hurt it because I would lose speed before a steep hill or something. And then the motor would have to work extra hard to get me up that hill. Overall, this bike has a solid range, and especially on pedal assist level 5, getting nearly 40 miles was pretty impressive to me.
So I wanted to take some time to talk to you guys about the cockpit on this bike. First off, you have an adjustable stem here, so you can tilt these bars forward or backwards to your preference. You can always loosen these bolts to change the handlebar positioning as well. Overall, this has been pretty solid. This handlebar is pretty thin overall. I'm not 100% sure what that exact diameter is, but I know it is a lot thinner than what we're used to seeing on this bike, and you do feel a little bit more flexing than on your typical bar. Moving up here, you have a pretty decent LCD display. It's low profile, which I like because I don't like those displays that kind of are all up in your face and make it hard to focus on the ride. So I thought this display was very appropriate for the bike. However, I'd probably move that to the center here because this bar has so much sweep. It's off to the side a little bit. You have Tektro hydraulic disc brakes on each side, which are solid brakes. I am a big fan of these brakes. They're connected to 160 millimeter rotors, which I went over in the brake test. As a whole, I think this cockpit should be pretty easy for people to learn. These grips are comfortable. And this throttle has a disengage or re-engage button. That's a nice little safety feature for this bike for those who don't want to accidentally engage the throttle when getting on or off the bike. This Shimano thumb shifter here is solid. I'm always a fan of the Shimano components. They know what they're doing. They've been in the industry for a long time, and you can just tell with the quality of their componentry. That's also a component that's easy to swap out at a local bike shop. They should have something for you in stock. These grips are lock-on, so if you don't get along with these grips or don't like the shape of them, they should be pretty easy for you to change out. So as a whole, you have a pretty back sweat bar. It is a little thinner, but keep in mind this isn't a performance-oriented bike. It is a leisurely, casual-oriented bike, so you're not going to need the biggest, bulkiest components on it. I think the riding position is comfortable, and I do appreciate the adjustment towers given us on this bike when it comes to the adjustable stem and the overall riding position as a whole.
So here at Electric Bike Report, we like to conduct what we call a circuit test, which is a 1 mile loop that we pedal in each assistance level to get a better idea of how each assistance level performs and the relationship between them. After we've completed this loop in each assist level, we can create a power curve to see what the assistance levels are like in relation to each other. The beach bump has a pretty linear power curve, meaning each jump is going to be pretty consistent with the one prior. Each jump should be around 1.5 to 2 miles per hour, aside from pedal assist level 4 up to 5. It did taper off a little bit there, and that was more around 0.5 mile per hour to 1 mile per hour on average. One thing worth noting is pedal assist level 1 doesn't really do much at all. You may remember from our range test that we got over 70 miles on this bike. And that's because pedal assist level 1 isn't helping the rider that much. When our test rider pedaled the same circuit with the bike turned completely off, he was only 0.1 miles per hour slower than in pedal assist level 1. This really shows that pedal assist level 1 might not be the best if you're just looking for a little bit of assistance. I would probably recommend pedaling in level 2 or 3 if you want that kind of organic classic bike feeling with maybe a little bit of help here and there on the hills.
So we are here at our brake test in our favorite parking lot. We set up cones on 5 foot increments, 25 feet total, to get a good idea of how the bikes we test and review stop from 20 miles per hour. I think 20 miles per hour is a good indicator of how strong these brakes are because there is a lot of momentum behind the bike. So I'm going to be doing 5 total tests, all from the mentioned 20 miles per hour, to get a better idea of how these Tektro hydraulic disc brakes perform. I'm happy to see hydraulic disc brakes on this beach bum, but but they're connected to 160 millimeter rotors, which is a little bit smaller than I'm typically used to. I guess time will tell how they do, so let's get started. So I just finished up the brake test and it took me an average of 18 feet to stop. That was from 20 miles per hour, 5 total times. My impression is the stopping power from the brakes is there, but there is a lot of vibration and flexing I'm feeling in these handlebars and the fork here. I definitely felt the fork move in and out in a vibration style way, and same with these handlebars where I felt them flex a little bit. It didn't seem to be the most strong bike when it came to braking full force. However, I know this is a beach cruiser. You're not going to be going for the world record on any sort of time trial on this thing. It's just something to be aware of, that these handlebars are a little thinner, and I think that fork might not be as thick as some others I've tested. Because of that, there is some flex and vibration that I did feel. With all of that taken into account, I do like the brakes. I would like to see them hooked up to a little bit bigger rotors, perhaps 180 millimeter rotors, and maybe a little bit thicker diameter on this handlebar and thicker alloy on the fork, just for security, just so the bike feels more like one piece below you. Overall, our result was decently solid. It sits kind of in the middle of the pack of the bikes we've tested so far this year. Alrighty guys, so by now you should have a pretty good idea of what this beach bum is all about, but let me talk a little bit more about the overall comfort and handling that I experience. So I think this is a pretty comfortable bike when the motor isn't causing some vibrations. Because this is a fully rigid bike, a lot of those vibrations travel through the bike and into your body. As far as other things that I would like to see on this bike, I think with the handlebar sweep being so big, this display should be centered. Reason being is with the way the handlebars are, the display is kind of off to the side like this. If it was centered, it would be a lot easier to glance down at and interact with when you're riding. I would also like to see this bike just be a little bit bulkier. The handlebar radius and the fork just felt a little thin and hollow to me. When I was doing the brake test, I did notice some flexing there. When none of that stuff is going on, I actually do really like this bike. The pedaling position is nice. I think the seat is very comfortable, and so are these leather grips. The way it handles, it's fun to get low in the corners. These 26-inch wheels with the 2.3-inch 5 tires feel like a really good beach cruiser combo. They're voluminous enough that they kind of smooth out the surface you're riding, whether that's the cracks in the pavement or the boardwalk. And I think that they're on the right track here. The feedback that I mentioned is something that I would definitely like to see on the future models, but with all of that taken into account, I still think that this is a solid bike for its price point. I really appreciate you guys watching the review today. I hoped I could inform you a little bit more about the Beach Bum 2. If there was any questions that I didn't answer, be sure to check out my written review. I did a full written review on this bike, and it should answer any of your questions. Be sure to leave a comment on what you thought of the video and what you'd like to see us review next. It is always a good time to see what you guys are thinking of the videos and kind of where you're at in the e-bike space. Next to that description in the bio, you'll see a like button and a subscribe button. If you hit both of those, you help us out a lot. With all of that being said, this is Towers Beach Bum 2. I'm Pierce Kettering with Electric Bike Report, and I'll see you next review.